Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Melody. Thank you guys so much for supporting me, for subscribing, liking, commenting. I just really appreciate your support in general. I'm almost at 5,000 subscribers, which is really amazing. So honestly, thank you guys so much. If you're interested in seeing what I picked up for today's Zara haul, then please keep watching. So for today's outfit, I'm wearing this ribbed long sleeve top. And then these jeans are from Pretty Little Thing. They're the mom jeans, and these are probably, maybe not this shade, but just in general, the PLT mom jeans are my favorite. I think that they surpass Zara mom jeans because they're just so much more comfortable, and I feel like they're shaped for an hourglass figure. If you guys are looking for really good mom jeans, I think that I found the one. I have multiple colors in these, so I definitely love them. As for the top, this top is so hard to get into. Oh my god, wow. The first time that I put this top on, I literally got all of my foundation on the neck and it ruined my makeup. So if you guys do pick up this top, just letting you know that it's gonna be a struggle to get into. Wearing it, it's very comfortable. Like, it fits perfectly fine everywhere on my body. It is like a little tight on the arms, but it's not that bad. Like, it doesn't feel uncomfortable. And on the neck, like, as I'm wearing it, it feels comfortable, but it's just getting your head through it initially is just, it's a struggle. I had to put a garbage bag over my head and then put the top on, and I still managed to get like a little bit of makeup on it, so. Yeah, I picked up this Coward set. It's like a loungewear jogger set, and the material is so soft. If you guys get this, I don't recommend getting the white. I don't know what I was thinking. I love wearing white all year long. I literally dirtied it like 2 seconds into wearing it, which was kind of annoying, but that's what you get for wearing white, I guess. It's super cute because over here at the waist, you can like cinch it in and tie it up. It adds like a different style to your outfit, which I think is really cute. It fits pretty comfortably. I got it in a size medium for the top and the pants, and they fit perfectly. I just want to let you guys know, I was scrolling on TikTok. One of the girls picked this up and she was doing the try on clip, and all of the comments were pretty much like, don't throw it in the dryer or else it's gonna shrink. So if you guys get this, yes, it is extremely soft. You're gonna love wearing it. It's gonna be super comfortable. Maybe throw it in the wash and not the dryer. I'm sure the instructions on the actual clothing will tell you what to do, but I don't like reading those instructions. I don't know why. That's just too much effort for me. Surprisingly, this is not see-through. I really thought it would be because obviously it's white. I didn't wear it with any like bright colored underwear, so like when I tried it on, it didn't look see-through. I picked up this sweater vest, like a ribbed knitted material. It's really soft as well and really comfortable to wear. I picked it up in a size large because I wanted to wear it with like a long sleeve button down top, and I have like a bunch of those tops from Zara. These are the ones. They're honestly so amazing. Like, you need these in your life because there's so many ways to wear these types of tops, and they're so like soft and comfortable, and they're super flowy. I would say this is a trendy piece. It's up to you if you want to like buy it. The way I styled it, I thought it was pretty cute. It's more like preppy chic. So if that's your vibe, I'm sure you'll love this. I picked up this bodysuit. It's in the like sportier section for Zara. It's like a ribbed material. It's cotton. It's very soft and has like a racer back. I really like it. It's super comfortable to wear. I got it in a size medium, so it's true to size. It is really stretchy and super comfortable. It's not see-through as well, so you're good. But obviously, you know, wearing a nude bra is like the way to go. The only thing is, it's kind of like has a grandma butt. I don't understand why Zara just can't do thong bodysuits. When it comes to this type of bodysuit, I feel like you're gonna have to wear like thicker jeans with it because it will show the line on your butt. Okay, so next up, I picked up these like wide leg jogger style pants. I don't know, I forgot what they're called, but I was rooting for this. I'm telling you, I was really rooting for this because I felt like it would have been such a cute look. Like, you could dress it up, dress it down. You could wear like a bodysuit underneath and like a really comfy teddy coat. You could do like a monochromatic look with it. I don't know, I was just vibing with it on the website. And then in person, girl, it's see-through. Like, you did this for what? Like, Zara, why did you do this? I'm pretty sure a majority of the people don't want to wear see-through pants. So I was really disappointed in this because like I love the color of it. It was really comfortable to wear. It fit perfectly, but you could literally see like my full underwear, the shape of it, the colors. I'm definitely returning them. I picked up this knit sweater. It just didn't look good on me. It wasn't what I expected. Got a size medium because I knew that it would be oversized. It was a little bit too big on the neck area. It kind of just made me look like I was drowning in the sweater. And because it's really boxy, it didn't fit my figure well with the wrist area. It's sewn shut, so it kind of just, I don't know, it just felt like I was drowning in it. As for the length of it, it kind of went to like a weird length for me. Like it's not necessarily like a sweater dress, but it's not like a sweater that you could tuck into your jeans. If you have like a slimmer build, I feel like you could probably get away with wearing this as a sweater dress and you could just pair it with some knee-high boots and that would look so cute. I picked up this loungewear set. This top I got in a size medium and the pants I also got in a size medium too. It's really comfortable to wear despite the material being a bit itchy. That's the only thing, like it's kind of weird, like it's itchy but comfortable at the same time. I don't get it, but that's just how it is. It's really stretchy. With the top, it is like ribbed at the back over here. It fits really nicely and it looks really cute. If you guys are looking for like a fancier loungewear set, this would be awesome. But if you just have sensitive skin, you're probably not gonna like it. You probably won't feel comfortable in it. Listen, you need this in your life. When I wore this, I felt so powerful. I felt like I was the CEO of Tesla. Honestly, like Elon Musk, I'm coming for your head. Zara, you really killed it on this one. I love the color. You guys probably think that I'm obsessed with the color green. I promise I'm not. It's not my favorite color, but with like this whole room setup, it's green, so I can understand why you guys would think that. I do think green is my color, and I do really like the color green. I like all shades of it, but it's not my favorite color. So with this blazer, you just button it up inside so you don't see the button like that. Tie it up, and you cinch it in your waist, and it kind of has that like peplum style. I got the blazer in a size medium. It fits super comfortable. It looked so good. I'm not 100% sure if the pants are high-waisted. I think they're kind of like a mid-rise pant, so it wasn't like the most comfortable for me because I prefer high-waisted pants. With this, because it's not stretchy at all, I probably would go a size up. I feel like that would be more comfortable for me because I do have like a larger butt. I just feel like if I had went up a size, I feel like there'd be more room for everything going on down there. If you are like slimmer, you could probably get away with just your size, but if you are kind of like a mid-sized girl and you're a little bit thicker, then you probably would want to size up. The next loungewear set that I picked up is this. It's kind of like a ribbed soft material. It's very similar to the material of this, but just slightly different. It's so soft and really comfortable to wear as well. It was really stretchy and it looked really amazing on. This is what the leggings are like. They're just super stretchy inside the material. It's just like a really soft, it feels like a corduroy velvet type of material. I picked up this top. It's like the asymmetrical, the one sleeve cutout type top. I love how this top looks on. I love the color of it. The color is beautiful. It is like a rib material and it is like a bit stretchy when it comes to like the body of the top. And it does also have like a shoulder pad here, so it gives you kind of structure. The thing is, the arm is just so tight and I don't know, I got a size medium and it does fit. The like seam over here is just too tight, so it just kind of like feels uncomfortable on your arm. If you have like really slim arms, you're probably not gonna have that problem. But if you do have like some meat on your arm, like I do, you will probably feel like a little bit discomfort, as well as when you're wearing it, like this is super tight. It's not the most comfortable top. I love these. They fit so comfortably. I feel like this would be perfect for like a lot of outfits. You could dress it up, you could dress it down. I wore it with this top and I paired it with some white dad sneakers and that was such a cute look. It's high-waisted as well and it's really comfortable too on the waist area. Like you don't feel like you're being sucked in. Like some pants at Zara, they're just too tight on the waist. Whereas these ones are perfect. And this is what the back looks like. Except these are like like really in trend right now. They give me rain boot vibes. They are more of a trendier piece, so I don't know how long these will be in style for, and they are really expensive. They were $89, I'm pretty sure. If you're planning on getting like a lot of wear out of them, you can for sure pick them up. They're super stylish and I really love them for like monochromatic looks. The material is just so stiff. There's just really no bending to it, so when you're walking or driving or sitting, like you could feel the pressure of the boot on your calf just under your knee. This is what the sole looks like. It's a chunkier sole, which I love. That type of shoe has been in style now for a while. They have a bunch of colors in this. They're really cute. I like them. Just keep in mind though that they're just like a really stiff boot, so it's probably not like the most comfortable shoe you'll ever wear. Picked up these boots. These are so cute. They're just kind of like a suede material, and I feel like the color of brown slash tan is the right color for me. They're a square toed boot, and then the heel is also square as well, and it has kind of like the fake wood type heel. And this is what the shoe looks like underneath, and they're just really comfortable on. I would say it's like a little tight over here where your calf is. It is like a tiny bit stretchy, and then it just has like the gold detailing zipper. And then this is what it looks like inside. It kind of has that like soft material. The boots maintain its structure when you're wearing them. It doesn't like fall down. I also forgot to mention that my necklace is from Zara. They have like a new zodiac slash like alphabet letter necklace thing going on. So you could pick up your initial. It's in a nice gold color. I think they do have silver if I'm not mistaken, but you know me, I love my gold jewelry. It's kind of like a bubble letter, and then the chain detail is really nice. It was $25. Pretty affordable and really good quality. Next, I picked up this purse. This is what it looks like on. The leather material is really nice, really good quality. That's what it looks like inside. Like a little pouch over here. So if you have like something that you don't want to get lost in your purse, there's some space there for that. I just think it's really big. I don't know. I love smaller purses. It is really cute and super stylish. It's just like a little bit too long and big for me. Picked up this knitted long sleeve ribbed crop sweater. That was a mouthful. This is really cute on. I really like it. It's super comfortable. It's very stretchy and really baggy. It's just like a really cute basic piece that you can't go wrong with. Next up, I picked up this blazer. It's more fitted on the waist area, so it kind of cinches in, if you guys can see. It kind of gives you like a bit of a curve at your waist, so if that's more your thing, you would probably love this. It is really good quality, as all Zara blazers are, and it has shoulder pads here, so it gives you more structure on the shoulder. I got it in a size large because I prefer wearing blazers that are a little bit oversized, at least one size up, unless it's already like an oversized blazer, just to give more room for what you want to wear underneath. I also picked up this mock neck vest. This one's like a charcoal, a deeper gray type color. Really comfortable. It's super stretchy, so you don't have to worry about it feeling uncomfortable. And I got this in a size medium large. You definitely have like some space and some room, and the material is really soft as well. What I love about these types of tops is that it's very transitional. You could wear it during any season with blazers, cardigans, or on its own, and it's perfect for every season. I picked up these leggings, and they're the rib material with the like line going down the entire leg, and then over here at the end it has like the flare cut out here, so it shows your shoe. These remind me of pants that I would wear in high school. These just remind me of like what I would wear in like grade 8 or grade 9. And yeah, just bringing me back to those high school days. I hated high school. I don't know if you guys hated it or loved it. These are so cute on. Honestly, they're really stylish. If you wanted, you could pair it with like a hoodie or a bodysuit or like a knit sweater. It could be anything. I would say though that these are another trendy piece, so if you are planning on picking them up, just know that they probably won't be in style forever. You can get like a lot of wear out of it. And they are really comfortable because they are leggings and they are stretchy, but at the same time they're tight and compressive, so they kind of like suck you in, and it looks really good on. I got them in a size medium and they fit me perfectly, so if you guys maybe are in between sizes, feel free to size up. You won't go wrong with that. It would be like less compressive, but if you want, you could just get away with your size and it would fit perfectly fine. I picked up these leather trousers. They kind of remind me of the Melania pant from Aritzia, but they're not like $500. I'm being dramatic. They're not $500. I think they're like $200. No, I'm not. No, I'm sorry. I'm not spending $200 on a pair of pants. They're super similar to the Melania pants, but they're not like $1 million, which is amazing. So if you've been wanting those pants but you don't want to drop a pretty dollar on it, I definitely recommend these ones from Zara. They're pretty much very similar. They have the like seam going through the knee area, and they're the wide leg straight leg pants, so they're really comfortable. And they have pockets over here on the side, and then they have pockets over here at the back, and then they just have the button over here and then the zipper. So they're really easy and really comfortable to get into. The thing is, Zara recommended a size large for me. Totally understandable, because I usually get size large when it comes to their leather leggings, just because they usually fit like tighter. But for these, I would recommend that you just get your size. So I feel like a size medium would have been perfect for me, because these are really loose. They're really loose on the waist in like the front and the back, and then they're really loose for the leg area. So I definitely would have preferred a size medium. So the last thing that I picked up was this leather skirt. I love the color of it. I felt like this would be really cute with a beige oversized knit sweater and some knee-high boots. But the problem is, I couldn't get my butt into it. Like, it just fits so tight. There's really like no stretch, just very little stretch, and it's so short. So my butt was hanging out of it. Like, I just couldn't zip it up, which is really annoying. I have two skirts from Zara. One is leather, which is literally this exact skirt but in black, and I got a size medium and that fits perfectly. Whereas this one is tan and it's in a size medium and it doesn't fit. So just keep that in mind if you guys are shopping online and you get different colors of the same item and it doesn't fit. It's not your fault. That's all for today, guys. Thanks so much for watching. I really hope that you liked today's video. Let me know which piece was your favorite, and if you are gonna pick anything up, I would love to chat with you guys in the comments. So thanks so much for watching. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.